It really is. The penalties were something. We felt like we have a disciplined football team, and there were some penalties in there that obviously showed opposite of that at times. But there were some penalties in there that I thought were, tough calls. Quite frankly. But at the end of the day, there was several that were correct calls, and we need to be better on that. I thought defensively on third downs, we obviously picked it up quite a bit. I think they were 1 for 15 on third downs on conversion. So our guys did a great job on defense to get that switched and go. So, I think we held them to 65 plays or 66 plays on offense, which is usually a pretty good day at the office if you're looking at by just strictly numbers on things. So we felt good on that. Offensively we had 88 plays, and usually you're looking at that saying that's pretty good too. But we weren't good on third downs on offense, so that's something we got to just continue to get better at. It plagued us a little bit on Saturday. There's times just not getting off the field. I felt like we had a couple huge plays that hit, and then all of a sudden we're getting called for illegal procedure because we don't have enough guys in line of scrimmage, or an offensive lineman's moving his hands, pointing out to something when we have a motion, and they're calling penalties on stuff like that. So, it's just those things. I think, we moved the ball up and down the field. We just didn't score. We kicked four field goals, and Brad did a great job kicking the football. I'm proud of him knocking those through when we called on him. That operation, with the snap, kick to hold, and blocking up front was really good on special teams, so I'm happy about that. But offensively, we got to find a way to get it in the end zone and take advantage of some things. You mentioned the turnovers. We took the ball away twice and had another fourth down stop that was gave us good field position. So taking advantage of those opportunities is something that we have to just continue to get better at. I mean, we ran the ball for 240 yards. I mean, you look at the numbers and it's just crazy. The only number that we didn't like on Saturday were penalties and final score. That was about it. So we got to get better. And I talked to our guys after the game, and it's not about anything right now besides the little things. It's about doing things right and practicing better, and that's on me as a head coach. We got to make sure we're getting our guys to do that and understand that. But the urgency is something we have to keep improving on, and hopefully we'll get that done this week in practice.
Kind of going off my last question, again, like you said, to reiterate, I mean, you guys obviously controlled first down big time. And it seems like the flow of the season's kind of helping you guys out on offense. You guys are controlling possessions, and it seems like you're at least walking away with three at this point every drive.
Yeah.
How confident are you that things are going to keep rolling that way on offense, and then things are going to get figured out eventually?
Well, what I'm confident about it because we have really good football players first off, and we have a really good coaching staff on offense. Coach Kilmer's been doing this at Angelo State since I've been here as a head football coach, and has done an unbelievable job of getting our guys ready to compete and play. And if you take a look at the film and see it, we're close to being really good at it, but it's not hitting right now. And again, I said this before in a couple different interviews, the ball bounces your way sometimes and it doesn't. It's shaped funny. It's not like a basketball or a volleyball, and it's going to go your way sometimes and it's going to go away from you. And right now we're kind of feeling like we're playing good at certain times, but that every time that ball bounces, it bounces away from us right now. But you got to make your own breaks. You got to go out there and continue to get better. And I think we've done that. I thought Braden, at the quarterback position, he played most of the snaps, on Saturday. I thought he did a really good job of, continuing his progression of being a really good quarterback, and because he is, he's talented, utilizing his skill set. Things obviously we still want him to continue to work on, and Coach Kilmer will get him coached up in what we're trying to do and continue that progression to get him where we need to be. But, I'm confident. I am. I think that there's too many talented kids around the quarterback position. We mentioned last week, I didn't feel like the O-line played very well at times where, that hurts a quarterback. Well, I thought the O-line played really well this weekend. When you run the ball for 240, you feel good about that. But, it's a continuation of just improving, and hopefully our guys understand the urgency of it. We don't want to be 0-2 right now, but we are, and that's the reality of it. And we start conference play this week, and we can get it turned around in conference. And at the end of the day, you want to win them all, but being your number one goal of winning a Lone Star Conference championship, that's still in front of us. We can do that. I also think what's encouraging about it too is we played two really good football teams. we've tested ourselves and see where we're at and where we got to do to win those games. And to win in the Lone Star Conference, it's not a false sense of we go play somebody not at the caliber of those teams and we beat up on them, we don't see the issues we got to work on right now, so that's something that I think that is good for us. Emporia State, Fort Hays, very good football teams. In my opinion, both games we were in and had a chance to win, but we didn't. And so now that's a learning curve for our guys to understand we got to play better. But at the same time, I think we're a pretty good football team, and we're excited to get back into play some Lone Star Conference, run and see what we can do there. Probably more so for the mentality of coaches and kids, on that part. But yeah, there's urgency to it. It's still a long season on that part, but yeah, there's definitely some urgency. That's a good question. I mean, the answer is yes, but at the end of the day, going to win a Lone Star Conference championship is something that we still have a grasp on and have an opportunity to go, do. Do we have to play better? Yeah, we do. And hopefully we've learned some things from these games to keep improving and work towards that goal.
To kind of transition to the defense, I know we spoke a little bit about the offense, obviously. You mentioned in the offseason, Andrew, and I'm trying to think of the other gentleman's name, both were supposed to this year, you projected to play lights out, and so far through the first 2 weeks, they each had an interception, and the defense has given you guys multiple chances. How confident are you going forward that this defensive, that these defensive plays are going to keep going?
Well, the other one is Eric Rasko. Those two guys, Andrew, they've both been proven, all conference, all American caliber football players for us for a long time. We're reaping the benefits of getting those guys for a senior year. Andrew didn't play week one. He was out. So getting him back week two in the first game that he got to play, and there he is getting an interception again. He's doing what Andrew does. So having those guys, Eric is just the true leader of this football team on defense and as a whole, the whole unit, the offense and defense. He's probably the most vocal and positive young man that I've been around. And having those guys back in your lineup and playing for you on defense especially really helps, having that talent coming back. So excited about what they've done so far in their careers, but I'm even more excited about what's going to happen moving forward.
Last